Well, if any, it's quite clear to me that Jesus is about to go on a cross and be killed for being the representative of God. So if anybody wishes to follow after, that's to say be disciple of Jesus, it's the same fate for you. We are like sheep to the slaughter, Paul said elsewhere, remember that? Those are sensitive areas where people are not willing. I think that Governor Huckabee was right when he said Jesus would not run for president. He couldn't. It's a very logical point. You can gain the entire world now, but at what cost? If you haven't gained your soul, and you have a right to disagree, but you're going to have to think this out very carefully. Christians shouldn't be killing each other. They do in wartime. That's not good. We better plan on being ready to be killed, or shunned, or cursed. Now, if we do get to the point of being cursed, there are people out there who hate what we're doing. And you don't hear that preached. The faith gospel people are particularly bad in that area, right? You're going to be rich and prosperous, right. Successful. I know this is a sensitive area, and I think on Memorial Day, people who go out there to risk their life on my part, I absolutely see that. My only question is whether Jesus would have done it, and I'm not yet convinced that when he says, put up your defensive sword to Peter, put that defensive sword away, Peter, because everybody who takes the sword will perish with the sword. Better hear that. You know, Luke, they go away and get two swords, and Jesus says, okay, that's enough. Two swords is enough for the prophecy to be fulfilled that he was to be reckoned as a common criminal. That's what that was for. Deliberately. But when Peter then gets his sword out to whack back, you get this very universal statement about everybody who takes the sword will perish with the sword. So the best argument, and I may be wrong, I mean, I'm still open to this, I think, but in wartime, Christians have killed each other. Oh, yes, they have. I'd be very sure, because you might find that isn't a good idea. By this will all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Conscientious objector is the way to be from our angle, and you have that privilege here. I would object conscientiously to having a gun and killing other people, because I would be scared that Jesus might not like us. Obedience, that's the obedience of faith, the obedience of faith. This is very easy. You cannot disobey Jesus. So I'm hesitant about killing my enemy. I've got to be, here's the way I'm looking at this other question. All right, I've just shot my enemy, and he's on the floor with the blood coming out of his ears. All right, Jesus, I'm hearing you saying, love your enemies. Did I do it? I'm not sure. That's why I hesitate. I'm scared. I'm terrified of getting this wrong, but I can still get it wrong. I may just be wrong. But we better be careful about loving our enemies. Not easy. You can point out that the early church, for what it's worth, historically, there were no Christians in the army until about, what, 280 AD? Rightly or wrongly, those people felt that's not something we can do. And they could be wrong, so it's not an absolute knockdown argument, but it's at least interesting. And of course, other jobs in the state are just fine. If you're working in the tax business and other things, wonderful. You're not doing any harm to anybody.